inspired by it because we were like stuck in this little motel room and some man had followed us and had the A&W root beer. It was kind of creepy under. But anyway, there was like these killer whales on just like Discovery Channel or something killing this mother and like child whale. It just seemed so funny. Whatever. So I just wrote this little thing. There, that's called Kissing Whales. There could be another one. Here's a dream that took place in the office room. A dream watercolor because dreams are like water, colors, dangerous. This one seemed dangerous only at first, but then it kept getting unexpectedly better. There was a boat in the middle of the ocean, not an ark, a large ferry boat for transporting passengers from one landmass to landmass. Something very large banged into the boat from beneath the hull, and everyone on the boat moaned in terror. It happened again, then one more time, and then the entire boat shifted side to side in a swoosh that had everyone grabbing the rails, vaulting into bags, horror-stricken, because the guy in charge, not a captain per se, but someone on the lookout, had been watching for such things. All the pullouts and passengers were too wild to know what to believe. Was it a shark? They had seen sharks in the area, so they all ran to see for themselves, and upon opening their eyes out of their fear and looking at it, not just assuming that it was a shark, they realized the large creature was a blue whale, a beaver, and it needed help. As soon as everyone figured that out, the whale gave birth to so many baby whales, and soon everyone on the boat was holding their own baby blue whale, nourishing it, kissing it, and the little blue whales wriggled, and it's hard to believe there could be so many petite whales, like personal whales. Whales kissing whales, whales kissing humans. Little souvenirs. Some of the babies had tears streaming down the sides of their eyes. Some made humming sounds. Even a fancy gentleman who swore eternal hatred for baby whales. He even hated dolphins. He preferred sunshine on his shoulders to raindrops falling on his head. He was astonished, and he started to cry because he was amazed by the wonder of these kissing whales. And his own life and heart was seized by his superior intelligence and his obsession with reading. So the baby whale fell into his lap like a tube of his favorite lipstick, and he might have to wipe the lipstick off his cheeks from the whales kissing him that put them there, because the baby blue whales didn't understand such things, only that salt water, milk, and touch is all a baby blue whale needs. And this word, blurbs. It's just like a cute, cuddly thing that like they know it's like little kids like sort of glass like blurbs. Okay, one last piece. Too much water. Floods of one-liners and babies stuck in fluid. I have a beautiful friend who reminds me often the importance of a well-timed kick. To fight for what matters or what you think is right. The condescension of too many compliments, the genetics of yang, a blast of sunlight. I don't know what the future needs to be. I don't know what you need to do. In the horse latitudes, I feel compelled to make noise, to slap my heart and my hands up and down my arms, causing my face to wake up. Slow water without pulse or current, air without wind or breath, looking over. And some dead couple with bleeding lips on a boat, skin tarnished and sallow, repeating the same lines over and over. But the time I got sick from eating too many sugar cubes and cherries visiting my grandfather who's a mechanic workshop. His funeral maybe started or stopped, whatever it was I thought I was doing once. I caught a cold. The flights that I was to take to his funeral were grounded in the snow. I had to stay in a hotel. My station tubes collapsed from the ascent and descent. People looking at me helplessly on the plane as I'm screaming from pain, shooting my eyes picks from ear to neck to throat in a flash and forget everything. My brain starts floating in storms of madness. The ear doctor has me sit in a conical soundproof room with white side foam movie-like buttons and headphones. The faint high-frequency beeps, letting her know which ear is damaged or not. And they say nothing is wrong with me, and yet they can no longer hear deep. This irritation and confusion of words and sounds, I must be interpreting everything wrong and reacting just as poorly. Here I am in a motel room again, by myself, next to the highway, so I can hear the rush of cars and voices traveling, television, and anyone really, so long as there are not stupid promises and useless compliments. Beautiful, amazing, huh? Tell me I'm a bitch, totally fucking crazy. Don't tell me doom. How about something real, not detrimental or pointless? I am not a sad person. I am a tired and bullshit person. There are no fantasies swimming in my mind, or clever comebacks, or romance novels. I've never read much of those. I want to travel, make the right things of value without being overly poignant. I hate being stared at. Stop fucking staring at me. Just say something real that isn't more promise of how we're all going to die. So throw caution to the wind. You can't throw shit in a horse without tunes. Then it's like a boomerang stuck to your hand in one of those slow motion dreams where you need to run, but you can only run in place. Zip, zip, zip. It feels like my heart keeps wanting to stop, and it could be on its last beat. And then it beats again.